So DJ just got voted out, and I am so excited. Honestly, this has been so much fun, and I've been waiting for this for so long. Personally, I have learned a lot this week. I feel like my whole rant and spiel against DJ has been kind of like my hero week of the season. So I learned a valuable lesson. In Survivor, you can play the game of a hero and do well and win. It works. That's awesome. You can play a villain. Do whatever you want. They both work. So whatever game you want to play, go for it, guys. But I'm done being a hero now. Back to what I like doing best. Stabbing people in the back. So this game setup is now perfect. I gave Rachel like the whole spiel before voting out DJ, that she's not at the bottom and she has options, and she can come with me, Kevin and JT, and even Travis, and we can make that 5-person squad and run the game. However, on the same side, I also have another 5-person squad with me, Sarah, Sheldon, Rebecca, and Gabby. So pretty much, I put myself back in the middle, and I can decide whoever I want to go home. There is a tricky part to this, however, because oftentimes in Survivor, the person in the middle is the one who gets cut. So I am in a power position, but it's also the most dangerous position in the game. Who's ready for some chaos?
Yo, how's it going?
I tried everything I could today to get the votes off of DJ, but it just ain't happening for me. Yeah. So I have to just accept it and let him go. My only worry is that what happens now after he's gone, you know? Where does the target shift to after he's gone?
Yeah, I don't know where the target's gonna go, but I feel like Rachel's gonna get in with Kevin and JT. I was just talking to Kevin and JT, and they wanted to pull both me and you into that.
Oh, they want to do like little 5 with them?
Yeah.
I mean, I'd be down for that. I like all of them. They're all cool. You want to see, the thing is, like, I don't want to vote out Sarah, but I want to vote out Sheldon without her.
Gotcha.
You know? And Rebecca too. Like, I never talked to her ever. Do you talk to Rebecca? If you do, props to you.
Like, occasionally, but, like, not much.
Yeah, like, I don't know how she's still here and how it's working for her. I'm jealous. Put in, like, this much effort and is still here. It's like, goddamn you, Rebecca. But nah, bro, I would totally be down for the Rachel, Kevin, JT thing. I think that would actually be good for us.
Yeah, I think we'd be pretty set.
Yeah, because I know Sarah's not going to write either of our names down.
Yeah, so, which is good.
Yeah, so they'll be going for, they're probably going to go for JT. So if we could protect JT on the next boat and like blindside someone like Gabby, you know, I'd be down for that, you know? Something.
Yeah, sounds good.
Yeah, DJ's going to hate me after this one.
Yeah. But who's DJ not going to hate after this?
It looks like I have a minute to do a little confessional while we're waiting for the challenge. I would really love to win a challenge. I haven't won a challenge yet. I've been so close so many times, but I would really like to not have any votes for me for the first time in a tribal and just feel good kind of thing. so.
All right, welcome final night. Are you guys ready for your next mini challenge?
Actually, yeah.
Sure. All right, first things first, Rachel, take back immunity. Back up for grabs. For today's challenge, you have yourself 6 solo cups. Here's what you guys are gonna do. You're gonna start by putting your solo cups on a flat surface, okay? And what you're gonna do is you're gonna take one solo cup, you're gonna flip it face upwards. What you're gonna do is that you're trying to flip it to make sure it's landing down like this. Once you have it, you're gonna try to bring it back to the floor, sit down, and then try to get your feet up to create a pyramid. Okay, you're gonna do this 6 times. So once you get your first cup down, you prepare your next one, you flip it, try to get it down, you bring it down to the floor, and then you try to get your feet to make sure you level it up to get in the shape of a pyramid. 2 rules. The only times you can use your hands is when you're flipping the cup or when you're trying to move the cup down to the floor. At that point, you have to use your feet to create a pyramid. Once you guys create, the challenge is over when you guys create a 6 cup pyramid. 3, 2, 1. First person to do that wins immunity.
4 immunity. 3, 2, 1, start. Keep going, Sarah, keep going. Keep going, yep. Down, down, yes. So up to down, that's fine.
2.
Evan's already done already.
4. Kind of fierce.
I don't know if it's lit. Oh, come on, flip cup.
Yeah, you gotta use your feet. There you go. Aaron, the cups. Evan trying to do the cups. JT now moving down to his feet. Rachel now doing it now. Dara almost there already.
Oh shit.
Dara with 1 cup left. Dara almost got it.
Your hands.
And, you can only use your feet. This is your only warning. Rachel's almost there. Hey, you gotta use your feet still.
I'm done.
Rachel, that's it.
Yeah.
That's it. Rachel wins her 2nd individual immunity in a row. All right, good job, guys. Rachel, once again, immunity back
to you. Good job, Rachel.
Safe tonight at Tribal Council, guaranteed a spot at the top 8. Everyone else, after a long 28 days in this game, somebody's gonna get cut short. Grab your stuff, head on back. See you guys tomorrow for Tribal.
Okay, so it's top 9, Tribal Council tonight. I expect 1 of 4 things to happen tonight. 1, I go home. 2, JT goes home. 3, Ryan goes home. 4, Rebecca goes home. 1 of those 4 things is going to happen here today. Hopefully, me leaving is not the one. And hopefully not JT. It's just when you get to top 9, everyone has their own agenda. And they start seeing their end game and what they need the best. And that's when they start flipping on each other. And I think that's what's happening here today. Sheldon and Sarah seem keen on voting out Ryan, and according to Kevin, Ryan apparently is down to vote out Rebecca. We'll see. I don't really trust it at all. I I don't know. I have to go to work. I don't have much time to talk to people before the vote. I just have to hope and pray that what I've been told is the truth, and that's all I can do. Aside from that, it would be great to get someone like Ryan out this round because he's a huge threat to win it all, very likable. Those are the kind of people that become serious problems down the line, and I don't need that fucking up my game, so, you know, hopefully all goes well tonight.
Things last night seemed like they were going towards Travis. Today, life was quite quiet. I heard a lot of names, including Travis, JT, Ryan, and Rebecca. So last night I had a talk with JT. We really seemed to hit it off a bit, and it worked. It was great. I told him that I did not find a special idol or a special power called the Owl Peak Power.
Congratulations, you have found yourself an advantage called the Owl Peak.
And it allows me to go and see who voted what. I told him I actually lost points. Don't think he trusted me. On the same time, I heard that Sarah gave me information that said that Travis was going for Ryan. JT told me the exact same thing, that Travis really wants Ryan gone. A lot of back and forth, a lot of like lying, more lying than I really like to do. And some of it is just like not telling the full truth, but I hate lying, but I guess it's part of the game. This sucks. Now here's the question. Who the hell am I actually with? The truth is, I really don't know who I'm with. I started this game with Sarah. I've had moments in the last few days, last week or so, where I thought she might be going against me. Then I had moments where I felt we were back together. I just don't know how I feel. Ryan seems to finally have completely brought his trust into me. And I do not want him to go, and he's awesome. I would love him to win. I'd be so happy if he would win.
We're at a point in the game where I'm not really sure where we're going to go. I have an alliance with Travis, JT, and Rachel, and we've been talking about only needing to pull in one. Ryan seems like the best bet to do it, and that's what we want to do after the DJ vote. So the plan is for Travis and Travis and Rachel to try to pull in Ryan, and me and JT to talk to try to talk to Sheldon and see how that works. I already have a good relationship with Ryan, so hopefully that ends up bearing fruit. But that's all we really got.
So I reached out to Rachel saying, "Hey, what are your thoughts on this?" And I make sure that when I do it, I say, "Yo, Travis wants to make this alliance. What are your thoughts?" And I specifically say Travis because I do not want it to get out to the other side that I'm the one making this alliance. If I do, then I'm going to get cut. The capital, I don't know, capital something. I am literally seconds away from making this chat. I have all the names listed up when suddenly I get out of nowhere a call from Sheldon. So I'm like, I open up and I'm like, "Hey, Sheldon. What's going on?" And he's like, "I need to talk to you, and this is serious." And I'm like, "Ooh." I try to play it off and say, "I have no idea what's going on." And because I have no idea what he could be talking about at this point. Like, what's so serious that he could be talking about? And then he says, he asked me, "Is it true that you are making an alliance with Travis, JT, Rachel, and Kevin?" And my reaction is like, how the fuck did he know that? I was literally about to make the chat. I hadn't even made it yet, and people are already figuring out about it. And I'm like, oh, well, shit. So someone is definitely leaking everything. So I don't make that chat because I know that's going to be a bad idea if I do make the chat now. And it kind of put me in a bit of a corner, but not much because I'm very flexible. So I do play it off with Sheldon, and I'm like, no, I don't want to make that chat. I'm being asked to be in the chat. Totally not my move, even though it was. So then me and Sheldon are still talking, and then he tells me the words that you never want to hear ever. You are going to win the game. Like, I know I'm playing a phenomenal game, and I know I'm controlling everything right now, and I know I'm in the power position. I don't want other people to know that. The fact that Sheldon is even, like, realizing that means that my game might be getting a little sloppy soon. It means I have to kind of blow my game up a bit, or find a way to fly under the radar even harder so that I don't get snuffed out before the end game.
So what are we thinking for this vote?
Well, I think it's probably between Rebecca or Sarah. And I think I talked to each of you guys individually, so.
Yeah.
Ryan, what are you hearing from Sarah? I haven't talked to Sarah yet today, but last night she told me Travis, which is... But she is also, like, she always wants JT out, and, like, I don't know why she's always going after you, JT, but...
She's
like,
got a hard-on for me, dude.
Like, I'm trying to push it, her to go after Travis, but, yeah.
Let's see Rachel looking nice at work. She has to have to go to work. She has to go in.
I know, I never have to do this. I'm actually here.
Oh, my gosh.
Okay, so Ryan, are you down to vote Sarah for real?
Yeah, that sounds like what we're doing.
Well, the reason I asked is because last night she was trying to convince me to vote you.
What?
Last night she was trying to convince me to vote you.
That's the second time that I've heard that then. So yeah, she actually does want you. That I didn't believe it at first. So damn, okay.
Okay then.
That's why I'm asking.
So last night she told me all the merits on why voting Ryan makes the most sense. And I'm not going to lie, they do make a lot of sense. I'm not voting Ryan, hence the reason why I'm telling him.
Yeah, what are the reasons? I'm curious now.
You played a very good game. You've done well in challenges as well. Rachel, by the way, she thinks you're next on the list because you've done well in challenges too.
I assume so because I just won twice in a row that I knew I was going to be coming up soon. Because like I just barely beat her yesterday.
Correct. And she said, since Ryan is not immune this time, now's the time to take a shot.
Wonderful.
Well, so now I just have to keep winning immunities then, is what they're saying.
Well, if we take Sarah out, that's one less thing we have to worry about.
I think if we take Sarah out, the game is ours to run.
I am trying so hard not to get frustrated right now with JT, but it's really, really starting to get on my nerves that, like, any time an idea is proposed and I don't agree with it, he just asks a million questions and, like, doesn't trust me if I don't give a straight up answer right off the bat. Like, I can't just go off of information that I'm being given from other people. This isn't a game of telephone. This is a game of Survivor. And I'm not just gonna trust, like, one person's, like, thing. Like, I can't just go by word of mouth. I need to hear it from the people themselves. And, like, I don't know. I'm trying to stay calm. But that's really, it's frustrating me because I've tried saying to him, like, if you're gonna tell me stuff, like, I can't then just go to those people with all this information that you've told me and be like, yeah, I have all this, but I don't know where it came from, because I'm not gonna throw them under the bus.
All right, so currently the vote seems to be back on Rebecca, but JT says he has a plan to get Sarah, and we all know that I'm always down to get Sarah if we can. So right now the plan is for Ryan, myself, Rachel, and JT to vote Sarah. Come to the middle and do that. They should be voting, from what I hear, either Ryan or JT. Or I'm hearing Travis' name now, too. And then we're trying to convince Travis to either vote Ryan or Rebecca. So that way we can split it up, and then that way the four could win the day. That's the plan. I'm not really sure where everyone's at on it. Rachel says she's in. JT's been making this scheme. I'm afraid, though, because if we take this shot at Sarah and we miss, I'm pretty sure I'm the first one to go.
What's tonight? What are we doing?
Hey. I heard Travis. Is that still the plan?
So I think it was Travis. I also recently heard Kevin as a potential well.
Interesting.
Just because Travis has been at least giving some information through Sarah. So I think those are the two options up for grabs. Anybody have a preference?
Not really.
I don't.
I think Travis has said my name and Rebecca's name. So he's telling me they're going Rebecca. So I probably want that one out.
Well, there's pros and cons to each in my mind. I think the pros of Travis is we weaken Rachel. Like now she has Travis on one side and I think she has JT on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
I also think that Travis would not be
closer to Kevin than she would be to JT.
Who?
I think Rachel would be closer to Kevin, actually.
You think so?
Yeah. I think Travis and Kevin, because I know that she and Travis probably voted, was not voting for DJ at the last tribal.
And I also, so for me about Travis is, now that you think Travis is good for you?
Mm-hmm.
Like, hands up if you think Travis would vote for you in a section. Like, that's the truth. Like, I think Travis would 100% vote for me. Do I think Kevin would vote for me? I'm not sure. I think I could also tell Kevin not to vote any of you guys.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that, yes, we are potentially cutting off an information stream by voting like Travis, but I'm not necessarily, I don't know if what's the right, I'm not sure if Kevin's the right move. Right.
Are they fucking us?
That's what I think is going on.
What do you think is happening?
I think we're being lied to, and I don't know why, but...
By whom?
By everyone.
Everybody is fucking us?
I think everybody is fucking us.
My bum hurts.
Like, Travis is trying to tell me Rebecca, but I think he wants me out. JT told me that Sarah wants me out. And I was like, I'm not sure how much I trust JT, but I don't know if that's wrong either.
Well, I can imagine, JT just sent me a message that he's out and they're talking to me after. Okay. I could imagine Travis telling Sarah that he wants to vote you out, so Sarah just said okay.
Okay.
Travis went to tell JT. And I could see that happening, but. Like, I don't know if that was awkwardness or that was just Rebecca and Gabby being weird.
Yeah. Also, I'm on an off day, so maybe that has to do with it.
No, but I felt strange. Like, they weren't talking, like, nothing was going. But they also never talked, so maybe it was just, like, the norm. Tonight's gonna be a shit show, isn't it, folks?
Yeah.
What do we think of you, Ryan?
Sheldon?
Yeah?
You are my number one.
You are my number one.
Like, you are so number one that, like, I don't know where I was going with that, but you're my number one.
You are my number one. I want to be there too, with you.
Mm-hmm. I have to tell you. I have a thing.
Yes. What do you have?
And her last name is Idol.
Okay.
So, if we can use your advantage, then we can figure it out.
Okay, let's do it.
Yeah. Like, I didn't want to use it too soon because I feel like people are going to start gunning for me, but.
Okay, but next time.
I can't survive this round without telling you.
Well, thank you for telling me, but just tell me when you get it, because, like, I'm telling you everything, man.
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm going to use my thingy tonight. If the numbers are not on... if the numbers...
Would we use it to save, like, I don't know, if for some reason it pops up on, like, Rebecca or Sarah? Do we use it then, or is it just a you and me thing?
I think...
What?
I think it has to be...
Yeah, I agree.
And... Okay, so we have to think through how we're going to do this. Oh my god, I love you. Where did you find it? I'm so happy.
Yeah, I went searching the mountain again. And it was still there.
What? I went there. I went to the Northern Lights.
Yeah.
And it was there? I'm confused.
Yeah. I found one of them early by the Northern Lights. So that when Sarah used her Northern Lights one, I knew where to look.
I don't get it, but okay. You or me, I will tell you, Ryan, use it on Sheldon or use it on Ryan.
Yeah.
I will blatantly put that out there. Okay?
All right. If
the majority of the vote, let's say, is on Travis, or the majority of the vote is on somebody else, is on Kevin or whatever the fuck it might be, I will only say you need to use it if they put out an idol. 20 minutes ago, I got a lovely, lovely call from Ryan, who told me he has the crystal idol, which is amazing. He's a genius at finding stuff there in the wilderness. And what I'm going to be doing is I will be using my Owl Peak advantage. I will see who actually votes for whom, and then tell Ryan to play his idol on whoever it needs to be played on. This is scary. I'm not too sure if it's going to work, if it's going to backfire. This might be chaos, this might not be chaos. I don't know. This is really hard. This game is really, really hard. Try it, but don't. It's hard.
We're now bringing the members of our jury. Manny, who couldn't attend, Raven, Tad, and DJ voted out at the last tribal council. Okay, so first order of business. Rachel, you won your second individual immunity in a row this season. So how does it feel knowing you're safe?
Pretty good. It's a little scary winning two in a row, but I am happy that I'm safe tonight because I don't know what the heck's going on as we're getting down to like a smaller amount of people. Like I have no idea. So I'm glad I'm safe tonight.
So Ryan, before tribal council started, an advantage was played that no one knows what is happening.
Yeah.
What do you think it means?
I think it means I'm nervous and I'm scared and I'm very confused and I just want to go to sleep, and that's what it means.
Okay. So Sarah, what was camp like after Rachel won individual immunity?
Not quiet, but chaotic. There's only 9 of us left right now. So, you know, I think, I don't know, everybody has the conversations, but overall it's been quiet. At least on, I don't know, maybe about that, by the afternoon.
So Travis, with such a small group of people getting even smaller, how do you navigate this sort of situation to make sure they are not the target tonight?
It's tough because as we get deeper, bonds get stronger between people, and you know, it's hard to get them to vote certain people because of that. So you really just have to rely on your instincts and hope that the people that say they're with you are really with you.
Okay. So Kevin, last few rounds have definitely been chaotic rounds. The DJ round, not so much.
Do you think that pace is coming back up?
Yeah, that was the only vote we could all, like, agree on. We're back to chaos.
Oh, well, we're back to chaos. So, JT, what do you think is going to happen tonight?
I don't know. At this point, like, I think someone plays a make-a-wish advantage, and they can just wish for whatever advantage they want at this point. So, I have no idea. I've heard so many names. I just cannot tell you what.
JT, that advantage is called the that advantage is called the genie advantage, actually.
Okay. So, so Rebecca, definitely, like, for what I'm getting is that, yes, camp life is quiet, but right. Has there been a lot of side conversations that you think people are having, or do you think it's more so he said, she said, or they said?
I think it's a mixture of, like, everything. I feel like information is getting passed from one person to another, and then it's going to come around in, like, a full circle, and then that person says, like, oi, you said that name, and then they're like, yeah. It's quite late here, that might have just been a little nonsense.
Okay. So, lastly, Gabby, do you feel safe tonight?
No.
Everyone else, raise your hand if you guys feel like you're safe tonight.
The only person
that... Hey, Rachel's the only one that feels safe. Sorry, Gabby, you were saying?
The only person that should feel 100% safe tonight is Rachel.
Well, I do.
Yeah, you're the only one that should.
Rachel, do you want to give me your immunity idol?
I like to keep it. I'm sorry.
just wondering.
All right, so for this round,
I don't get a question. Why don't I get a question?
Oh, sorry, Sheldon.
And what's the advantage?
Yeah.
Okay, I cannot confirm or deny any kind of advantage giving information without the secretary's approval. So, Sheldon, since this big talk over an advantage is being played in the main chat, what are your thoughts on that? Do you think that changes people's minds of what the of what the outcome of the vote could happen?
So I about 30 seconds or so before you posted that in the chat, I found out who I was voting. So I had enough time to figure all of that out. So I don't think I can really control the game so much based on what advantages are played or not. We are at a point where it's gonna suck for literally anybody here to leave. Like, I'm going to be personally upset with anybody leaving. Like, it's anybody leaving here sucks. I like everyone here. I do not want anyone to go. Part of the game means that somebody has to go, sadly. So I couldn't adjust to anything. I don't fucking know. Wish us all luck. I'm scared.
All right. With that being said, I'll now pass the floor off to you guys. If you want to, like, say some final words, call somebody out, perhaps play something. If not, we will get right to it with the vote.
Okay, what about the advantage that we're supposed to talk about?
I told you, I am not going to say what the advantage is. And we're going to leave it at that.
All right, that's one shot.
Anyone else? Okay. Well, one at a time, I'll put you guys into a breakout room where you guys will cast your vote on who you guys want to send home. It is time to vote. Ryan, you are up first.
Sarah, I'm voting for you because you keep on throwing my name out there. I don't care if you have all these crazy advantages. Bye.
First order of business, your allocute advantage allows you to see who's going to be elected. Options here are the following.
out of the boats. If anybody has a hidden immunity item and they would like to play it, now would be the time to do so. Okay. Once the votes are read, the decision is final. Person voted off after the tribal council area immune. All right, votes. First vote, Travis. One vote, Travis. Sarah. Vote Travis, one vote, Sarah. Rebecca. Vote Travis, one vote, Sarah, one vote, Rebecca. Heaven. Vote Travis, one vote, Sarah, one vote, Rebecca, one vote, Heaven. Sarah. Sarah, one vote, Heaven, one vote, Travis, one vote, Rebecca. Travis. That's two votes Travis, two votes Sarah, one vote Rebecca, one vote Kevin. Travis. That's three votes Travis, two votes Sarah, one vote Rebecca, one vote Kevin. Sarah. That's three votes Sarah, three votes Travis, one vote left. 14th person voted as Survivor Pandemic Gaming American and the fifth member vote here. Travis. Travis, that's four. Knight, that's enough. You have 30 seconds to save the tie.
Good game, everybody. No hard feelings.
Game.
Travis? Mm-hmm. Oh, Travis spoken. Time me to go.
Instead of Travis. I don't even mean that. I'm so tired. So, like, fun. But yeah, that means that at least Travis went home. I know he's like, but it's okay. I was falling asleep on that.
I don't know why Kevin thinks I'm gonna give him information. He has voted for me almost every tribal. Almost. And then he comes to me like, so, who voted for me? Like, I'm not gonna tell you anything. Now, you come to me, lie to my face, and you expect me to give you information.
I wake up from the Travis spoke, feeling great, feeling rejuvenated, feeling like antibiotics are your best friend. I'm also feeling great because I just lied to Rachel, Kevin, and JT, and it was so much fun. However, it is a bit of like a risky situation to be in, because lying to people does not make them want to work with you. It makes them kind of want to target you. So yeah, I feel like moving forward, I'm definitely going to be their target, and that's not amazing. But if I am their target, then I still think I have the numbers with these people, with Gabby, Sarah. I keep gesturing to sides. I have like Kevin on this side of my body and Sarah on this side of my body. It just doesn't make any sense for me to go with Kevin right now. He's got no numbers, he's got no strength, he's got no power. Because I have all the power right now. It is though risky though, because he could want to go after me. But he can't necessarily throw me on the bus. Like, what's he gonna say? Sheldon, Sarah, Ryan's such a snake. He said he was gonna work with us, but he didn't, and he actually worked with you. Ryan is such a snake because he is loyal to you. Like, no, Kevin can't make that argument to them, because that's not gonna work. It's just gonna make them trust me more and get me deeper in their circle. So, I'm pretty much set, even though I lied with them. I do wanna kind of brush the bridges, because these are possible connections that can work for me later in the game, that I might have just burned a few bridges, but I can put out the fires and build a new.
So, Travis went home. I don't really have a plan here. I've been with JT since the beginning. I've worked with Rachel before. There's 8 people left in this game. I'm one of them. JT, Travis. JT, Rebecca. That leaves Rachel. At least five more. Sheldon, Ryan, Sarah, Rebecca, Gavin. Since it's 5-3, I gotta get one more here to make it 4-4. The biggest threats in this game are, in order, Sarah, Ryan, Sheldon, Rebecca, Gabby. Those are the five, and then that's the order against me. I have to try to pull Gabby. That's the only way to get this done. I've never talked to Rebecca, so there's literally no reason to start now. She's not going to trust me. There's no reason she should trust me. Even if she's 4 of 5, that's fine, I'm sure, by her, because she has no idea who I am, and I can't do that. At least with Gabby, I've worked with her before. So that's one avenue that I'm going to try. Another avenue I'm going to try is to try to talk to Sheldon, because I have no real path to win right now. And I felt this way before, but as my allies continue to go, you would think, okay, I have allies on the jury, but I have no way of getting there except by my own bridges, right? So I have to talk to Sheldon and explain that to him. I don't think it'll work because I think he's so locked in with Sarah, and me taking a shot at Sarah possibly upset him, but it is what it is.
So last tribal was a mess and a half and then some. Yeah, that was not what I wanted to go down at all. Losing Travis was a big hit. That sucks. I wish that we either just went for Rebecca, or if we were able to like tell Travis that Sarah was the plan. I don't really know why they were so set against telling him, because I feel like he might have been down, but who knows. Either way, he's gone. Nothing can be done about it now, and that sucks.
All right, welcome Final Eight. Are you guys ready for your next immunity challenge?
Nope.
Yes.
First things first, Rachel, once again, I'll take this back. Once again, immunity is back up for grabs. So, as you guys noticed in the main chat, today is Jackbox night, where you're competing for immunity with Jackbox.
Interesting.
So here's how this is going to work. We're going to be playing one game of Fibbage. And the rules go in as follows. You have to make a... each person is going to select a category. And then with that selected category, everyone gets the same question. What you got to do is fill in a believable lie that is best suited for that question. The more people that select your lie, the more points you get. And then we keep going for like 3 rounds. And the person with the highest amount of points by the end of those 3 rounds wins individual immunity. That make sense?
Yeah.
So what I'm gonna do is that I'm gonna drop the, I'm going to screen share the Jackbox challenge. Everyone should be competing. I am just gonna be screen sharing. I'm not gonna show you what stuff I put in or not. I'm not gonna be competing, you guys are. And you guys need your phone to have yourself be in control of what you guys do. You guys don't need to be on cam for this, but you can use your phone to operate for the challenge. So which means JT, Rebecca, Rachel, Sarah, you guys don't need to be on cam for this.
Not me.
We have arrived at the final finish. Everything rides on this one. Final question, and it's worth triple. Anybody can win it. Okay, here is your final finish question. The strange nickname of New Zealand's national basketball team. Write your lies now. Hurry! Okay, there's a truth out there. Find it. Okay, what did everyone pick?
Ryan got points there. Sheldon, Rebecca took a hit. Rachel got some in there. Kevin got points there. Kevin, Gabby, and JT all got 3,000.
And the rest of these lies didn't fool a soul.
This might put Kevin back. And with that, Ryan wins individual immunity. Near close.
Oh, man.
Congrats, Ryan.
Congrats, Ryan.
Congrats, Ryan. That was a good one.
Thanks, y'all. I was just having fun with that. That was a fun call.
So, Ryan.
Yeah, what's that?
Yours.
Wait, there's a statue? Can I see the statue?
Sure.
Oh. Damn.
Yes, sir. That is for you. Yeah. So, Ryan, stay from Tribal Council. Guaranteed a 1-7 shot of winning this game. As for the rest of you, Tribal Council tomorrow night, where one of you guys will be the next person voted off this game. Have the rest of the evening and tomorrow to figure out what you guys want to do. See you guys tomorrow for Tribal.
Probably going to try and take a shot at Sarah again tonight if Gabby is actually seeming like she's on board, because when we tried to have Ryan do that with us, it totally backfired. So, round two, see how it goes. I'm probably going to be using my extra vote. Because, like, I don't think this, I don't know if this is gonna work. I want it to work, I really do, but I'm not as confident with this one, so here's hoping.
Popping a call with Kevin, and Kevin's like, you didn't need that immunity, how did you win? And I was like, I'm the greatest liar, obviously, that's why I got the win for Fibbage. But then I can just lie about me not being a great liar, and it's like, Kevin, I just knew those questions. I just guessed on some of them. Like, big wheel of cheese, that's kind of British, right? Yeah, things like that. But Kevin is popping off on me saying, like, you didn't need immunity, and you could just see how upset he is and so distraught. He's like, Ryan, I really want to work with you, and I don't understand why you don't want to work with me, Kevin says. And, like, I love Kevin. Kevin is one of my favorite people. He's amazing. He is genuine, and he would be a very strong, loyal ally. And the fact of the matter is, if Raven didn't call out my entire game, then I definitely would be very comfortable going with Kevin. And I would have sided with him on that vote and voted out Sheldon. I would have loved to work with Kevin if the game was different. But it's not different, which makes Kevin bad for my game. Like, it doesn't matter how much you like the guy, he has to go.
But I cannot believe anything he says anymore. I just can't. Raven vote first time, he lied. Manny vote, he lied. DJ vote, he was on board, but that was Sarah's plan, so whatever. DJ votes a second time. Sarah's plan is still good to go. This time we tried to take a shot at the queen. It didn't work because I'm assuming he lied to me. So I can't believe him. I can't trust him. And in addition to all that, I did get winged by a vote yesterday. So I have no idea who even took that shot, but I don't care. It doesn't matter because it would have to be someone that I have not been working with, so either Rachel, either Rebecca or Gabby, or even Sarah herself. Who knows? Man, I've written Sarah's name down multiple times. Like three times I've written Sarah's name down. So if it was her, that's fine, but I just assume that I'm the next name up. And hopefully I can figure out a way out of this, but I don't know that I can.
Okay, so down to final eight. Ryan, you won individual immunity in Jackbox Night. So how does it feel knowing you're one step closer to getting to the end?
That feels pretty good. It was a pretty fun competition. So yeah, I guess I got no complaints about that.
So Kevin, before the day was up, I announced in the main chat that there's nothing left to search.
It means literally nothing to me. I have found nothing. I have done nothing but waste HP. And so, good. The rest of y'all ain't be able to find nothing else. All right? That's for the rest of y'all. Because for me, it don't mean jack shit. So, I'm looking at all y'all that have played stuff. Literally everyone except for Gabby, I believe, has played something so far in this game. So, keep it up. You can't find nothing else. You're going to have to use your own social game to get this done now. So, good luck with that.
Interesting. Sheldon, Kevin brought out a good observation that, like, with advantages being all, like, found and no one knows where the rest of them are, you now have to rely on your social game to get yourself deeper. So, what can you do to make sure that you're not the target tonight?
I don't know. This sucks. This is the worst. This is 100% the worst round of the game for me. Because this is the point for me. I've had no sob stories, but like I've actually been emotionally like, this is the night where every single player, every single person in this game is somebody I truly, truly like. And this sucks. This truly, I like you too, Raven. But this sucks. I wish I didn't have to vote tonight, but that's part of the game. To answer your question, I think I prefer to play the game without advantages, just because advantages are uncontrollable. Social relationships are controllable to some extent. You might be able to get reads, you might be able to get information, but this night sucks.
You make real bonds, man. You make real bonds in these games, especially in the Zoom version. Like, I've been lamenting this whole time how much I hate the Zoom thing, because when I play with just texting, I don't see your faces, I don't talk to you, I make decisions purely on strategy and not based on how much I like a person. I'm with Sheldon, I understand how this is, and I assume that this is my night, right? I assume this is my night, Sheldon. I assume this is my night, Sarah. I assume that this is my night to go. So, I just wanted to say myself that it's been fun, and I will probably be voting for Sarah if she makes it to the end of this game. Because
wow.
I feel like she's been playing the best game of everyone here. Raven doesn't like it. I see you over there sitting on that bench, and I'll come talk to you about it in a minute, girl. When I see you in Loser's Lodge in a couple minutes, I'm going to come talk to you and tell you what, she's playing the best game in the set. All right, but when I get there, we're going to talk about it, because we need to make sure we're picking the best player that has played the best game. And that's what I'm going to do. Listen, I know. I see you mouthing over there. I see it. It's okay. Okay,
Sarah. Kevin pointed out that if you get sent to jury, that's a vote for you to win. Is it a compliment or
target,
a warning?
for a target like I've been this entire game. My name has not been brought up at one tribal. I feel like the most popular girl in the game. It's either going to bite me in the ass or I'll make it to the end. Who knows? But I think it's more of a target at the end of the day, being called out so much.
Interesting. Okay. So, Rachel, Kevin pointed out the fact that he believes that he has the vote tonight. Does that ring true to you?
Honestly, I have no idea what's going to happen tonight, just because last night went, or whenever, last tribal went, like, completely different than I expected it to in many ways. So, I'm really, like, I don't know what to expect. But, yeah, that's all I got.
All right. So, JT, last round was a little bit of a messy vote. Did you manage to pick up the pieces and see what went wrong?
Yeah. I don't think I have enough pieces, Josh. That's all I gotta say.
Okay. So Rebecca, every single round up to this point, something has been played. Are we expecting another one? Or are we all advanced to get it out?
I just hope they will, like, kind of, like, just expired by now, and then, like, they're not there, you know. Yeah. But I wouldn't be surprised if there's, like, a big one or something still, like, and someone's like, hey, I'm gonna switch this full game over. Yeah.
So, Gabby, lastly, we're getting down to near the end of the game. How important is jury management as slowly when the jury gets bigger, but by the near the end of the game?
No, it's definitely important. And if you're not thinking about that now, you should be. Because this isn't just about who can do the most strategizing or making the most moves. It's about who can get the votes.
Okay. And I believe everybody got a question. I will pass the floor up to you guys if you want to have some final words, maybe call somebody off. If not, I'll open up the breakout room and we'll get to the vote.
Sarah, that wasn't to make your target any bigger. You've had, like you said, a target from me. What is your nickname for me? What is?
And then of the Haters Club.
I'm the president of the Sarah Haters Club.
Leave the charge.
It's not that I hate her, and that's the hard part, right? And I didn't want to talk to her because I didn't want to like her, and I've grown to like her, which is why I hate the Zoom thing. Yes, Raven, this is what happens when you talk to somebody. You grow to like them. That's what happens. So it's not that it's a hater. It's that I feel like she was playing a good game, and so that's why I have gone for her as much as I could. But when my guy Travis went, I knew that the time was up. So I just wanted to give you your props because I don't think I'm going to be able to say them too much once we get to the final tribal council. And if you're there, I'm not going to be able to give you your kudos. So I wanted to give it to you now. I've been trying, man. I've been trying. Hasn't worked. But I felt like I had to cut it out, Raven. Cut it out. It's good times though. So, Betty, Ted, Rachel, you guys will
do. Okay. With that being said, I'll open up the breakout room. And one at a time, you guys will cast your vote on who you want to send to the jury. In that case, it is time to vote. I'll move. I'll bring the person closest to my screen. So in this case, that is Sheldon. So Sheldon, you are up first.
Voting for Kevin because it's finally time for him to go.
I'm voting Sarah because this is maybe the last time I'm writing Sarah's name down. But no, it won't be the last time I'm writing Sarah's name down because I legitimately will be writing it down. If I am out, I will be writing her name down to win and she's there. But there's a plan in place and see if it works. There's multiple times I've been screwed by plans, they have never, ever worked. So let's see if this time can be different. I doubt it, but
you got to pop up your chance advantage. You're choosing
Yes, I do want to use it.
That's how the boats. If anybody has a hidden media and they would like to play it, now would be the time to do so. Okay. Once the votes are read, the decision is final. First voted off after the tribal councilor interview. All right, the votes. First vote. Kevin. There's one vote, Kevin. Sarah. Vote Kevin, one vote, Sarah. Kevin. Two votes, Kevin. One vote, Sarah. Kevin. That's three votes, Kevin. One vote, Sarah. Kevin, that's four votes, Kevin. One vote, Sarah. Sarah, that's four votes, Kevin. Two votes, Sarah. Sarah, that's four votes, Kevin. Vote Sarah. Sarah, tie. Four votes, Kevin. Four votes, Sarah. One vote left. 15th person voted as Survivor Pandemic Canadian Arctic. Sixth member of our jury. Sarah. Sarah, that's five. Tonight, that's enough. That 30 seconds is 5 minutes.
Hi, guys. It was great playing with you.
Good game, Sarah.
Good game, Sarah.
Sarah. Yeah. That's spoken. Time for you to go.
Bye, Sarah.
Well, I'd say with this vote, quite a blindside. Based on those reactions, definitely got some talking to do after this. Got the torch to head back to camp tonight. Some jury members may notice, but JT isn't present. That is because he has decided to medically evacuate from the game due to his constant struggles with the mental issues that he has been dealing throughout this game. Things have been a little bit overwhelming for him. He decided to take Chopper and leave the Arctic. So here's what this means. He will be part of the jury because he decided to do a medevac. This isn't considered a quick, because if it considered a quick, he would have just left the chat without telling us. This has been an ongoing issue for JT, and I respect his wishes, and nothing but the best for him. But at this rate, he is officially out of the game, but he still will be part of the jury, and he will decide who will win this game. Here's what also what this means. No tribal council tonight. We are moving on. Game continues. And Sarah's immunity, this Yap of Tundra, won't be valid. No one's at a clean slate. Does anyone have any final thoughts, concerns, things they want to express?
Yeah.
How JT self-evacuating from the game?
I'll say it. I wish for the best of JT, and I hope he's going to be all right once. He'll be okay.
I'll talk to him on the outside, but we'll figure out what happened. I'll talk to him later. This sucks.
Right.
I'll say something. I feel as though JT and I have been on the wrong side for every single round, even pre-merge, and I wish I you know. And just, I'm happy that he needs to do what he needs to do to take care of himself. But I wish I would have gotten rid of him. He would have gotten rid of him.
Came back. I know this wasn't what you guys were expecting, but we want to keep this game fun and make sure that everybody is in a good state of mind to finish off the rest of the game. And the last thing I want is to have people not being fully there in the game if things go south.
Yeah.
So now we're down to final seven. The game resumes tomorrow for your next immunity challenge. Enjoy the rest of your night off. Feel free to, like, if you guys want to talk to production, if you guys want to, like, talk to anybody else in the game on what just happened, maybe feel free. But there will be no vote tonight. JT will be added to jury, and we'll go from there. Grab your stuff out on back. See you guys tomorrow for your next challenge.